Hey, welcome to ToeJam and Earl. I hadn't played this game in probably about 15 years, and I'm just kind of doing a kick of old games, and it's Alien October, and these guys are aliens, so it all fits. I never played the fixed world before. I always played random. I've never played fixed, so that's what I'm going to do this time. And I guess this first area is not random, because this looks exactly like it always fucking did. The exit to this level is super close, very quick, very easy. One level already down. Oh, there's a ship piece here. Alright, so that's pretty nice. There's a ship piece on the immediate first place I get to. There's like a ton of levels in this, so you never know exactly where ship pieces are on random. I guess on a fixed world, they're in exact certain places. This is also as fast as I'm allowed to walk, because I need to get, like, fancy shoes if I want to actually walk anywhere. Hey, there's a ship piece! Got it. The rocket ship windshield. I'm already doing well. It's been years since I played it, but the game is fairly simple. Give me presents. Fucking dick, stop it. I don't want them to poke me off of the edge of the world, because if they do, I fall down. Ooh. I'm looking for the exit now, because it's an elevator, and if I fall down, I have to go back to the last level. It's not like it's hard for me to get off of that last level. I just don't want to have to deal with it. Oh. Well, that's a giant circle, so I don't think that that's actually a good idea. Giant circle is not a good way for me to go. Is it just me, or is that an island? Damn it, there's a present on that island. You fucking dick. He's coming this... You fucking dick. Yeah, don't come at me the whole damn time, fucking asshole. I can sneak. I got a fat ass sticking out of my fucking shorts. This is too realistic, man. Ah, there we go. Done with level two. I'd stick around and grab more presents, but I don't know where any of them are, and I don't know if there's even enough of them for me to care about. I guess it was too much to hope for that they'd give me a present on multiple levels right in a row, isn't it? I have multiples of a couple of presents. I think maybe I ought to use one of these green ones? Or maybe one of these red and white polka dot ones. Let's go with green. It's a boom box. Well, I guess if you're gonna stand there and dance to the boom box, that does not help me in any way. Trying to sneak around and somebody's calling a damn phone. That's inconsiderate when somebody is asleep. I think it's a bit... Look around. You see how dark it is? Oh, not a fucking hula dancer. I don't need to deal with a fucking hula dancer. Give me that phone. See the... Oh, there's the exit. That was easy. It's easy to find the exit when they just tell you where the fuck it is. More presents. Oops. Too many. Shit. Okay. I don't know what that is. I might be trading for something I don't actually want. That ain't good. You know what? I don't think I need this fucking boom box. So I'm just gonna drop the boom box here. Wait a minute. It's making them... Okay, no, that would have been useful then if it makes them dance. Shit. Well, I should have saved that one. Oh well. Fuck that. I'm not getting out of this goddamn elevator until that hamster goes the fuck away. Piece of shit. This is from back in an era of... Okay. Fucking bees. This is from back in an era where games were designed for... Specifically, games were being designed for kids. Games originally weren't for kids. Video games were for adults, originally. But The video game market crashed because so many people didn't want to play them. It wasn't a thing that people were playing often enough. So, Nintendo decided, and they saved the entire video game industry, they decided to sell video games to children and market them to children instead of marketing them to adults. Which is a pity, because games like this started coming out, and they're really good, but there's one major issue. Nobody had save features or anything like that. Ooh, I'm a doofus. Fantastic. Oh, goddammit. Fucking hamster. He's gonna run me over. He's gonna catch up to me and run my ass over. Motherfucker. Without save functions, without anything like that, a lot of these kinds of games, oh fuck you too, that guy will make me walk in random directions. God damn, man. They really like putting one of these fucking hamsters over next to me. A lot of these sorts of games had features about them that would, like, let you put in a code. Because we had a lot of games that my grandmother and my mother played that we didn't really care about all that much. Like, there was a casino game. Oh, fucking bees. All right. Well, gotta use the high tops because I need to get away from some shit. There was a casino game for the Sega, because we had a Sega when I was growing up. Ooh, there's a bridge. And that one actually had codes so you could sort of save your progress. You could save and load games so you could keep playing. Oh, shit. No, no, no. Get back on the goddamn island, motherfucker. This is the most precarious shit. But we didn't have that for these kinds of games, because they just presumed that you were a kid. And they designed it with kids in mind, which is kind of shitty, obviously. Don't you chase me, goddammit. No, no, no. Asshole. So anyway, all the assholes that live around here. I'm gonna follow the street. These almost always lead me to an exit, so I'm just gonna follow the damn road. So games like this didn't have save features or anything like that. They made them for kids and expected that you would just beat them in one sitting. But while I have time to do that, I do not want to put up a whole video that's like an hour and a half, 2 hours long. I mean, I don't know how long it's going to take to do this. And there's no way Steve's going to agree to edit a video that I recorded for 2 or so hours. With him having to edit it down to like 15 minutes. Especially because, well, feel like you'd lose a lot. Hey, there's the exit. Fuck yes. So, that's it. I became a doofus. I got one ship piece and then I'm done with it. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.